everybody, and welcome back to Mwack Attack, your place on the internet for all things photographic. My name is Missy, and I am here to guide you through the murky waters of professional photography. I consider it my mission, no, my quest, to show each and every one of you that being a true professional photographer is a heck of a lot easier than most people think. Well, today's episode is a little different because I was not only privileged, but blessed to go on location for a lifestyle children's shoot in Phoenix a few weeks ago. That's right, I was on location in Phoenix shooting two precious children by the name of Charlie and Sutton. And this session was a little bit different in that they both have been taking swimming lessons and their mom wanted to really showcase them in the pool. So you guessed it, we went to the pool for the session. And while I was there, I thought, you know, this is the perfect opportunity to share with you all what I do, because I understand sometimes you get to an on-location lifestyle shoot and you find yourself kind of floundering around, no pool pun intended, and you don't know what to do. And that can be kind of embarrassing. So I thought that I would give you some tips and tricks during my shoot to help you out a little bit. You know, let me help you. Now, the first tip that I have for you, if you've been watching my videos for any amount of time, it should come as no surprise. But for those of you who might be new, this might be your first video, you might want to pay careful attention because really, nowhere is it more important than when you're on location. Accessories are never more important than when you're on location, which is like all the time, am I right? You're not going to wear some boring old t-shirt to the pool where everybody's watching you. I'm rocking my Diet Coke t-shirt, and look down here, my pink Converse with mismatched shoelaces. I'm telling you right now, that says hip to everyone here. You feel me? You know how important clothing is and how important accessories are when you're shooting. You know, when you're out and about and you're, especially when you're photographing, anything, but especially children, seniors, you want to come across as really one of them. You want to be hip and trendy. I mean, you could throw on a boring old shirt and a pair of tennis shoes or something like Clark's, but that really doesn't convey anything, right? And you're marketing yourself while you're there. That's why I recommend really just finding the hippest shirt you can, the coolest, funkiest shoes. I mean, a Diet Coke t-shirt and a pair of pink Converse with mismatched laces. You know what that says? That says, I'm fun. I'm creative. Those unmatched laces say, I'm artsy. I mean, it might be subliminal. They might not notice it right away, but their subconscious does. Now, these two precious children were so ready for pictures. And, you know, I think that's important. They knew that Missy was coming, and they were ready. Hold on, he's underwater. Sutton!
Missy!
Sutton!
That was mine!
Oh, Sutton!
I'm having this!
Sutton! Sutton, you ready to take some really fun pictures?
No!
Hey! Wait! Sutton, can I take your picture now? Please?
No!
Okay, well, maybe they weren't that excited at first for pictures, but, you know, they warmed up. After shooting for about an hour and 45 minutes, we got some great ones. We really did. And yes, I did get sunburned, but I think it's a small price to pay to follow your dream. And, you know, sometimes we do pay for our passion and, you know, sunburn's just kind of Mother Nature's chemical peel, right? So I try to keep a positive spin on the whole thing. Now, if you notice, little Sutton would tend to swim away a lot. And some of you, if you had been in my pink Converse shoes, you might have been a little nervous that you weren't going to get the shot. Are you thinking what I'm thinking? Water's clear. I'm just going to say it. There's no need when you're at a pool to have the children or anyone on top of the water. Water's clear. And if they won't come to you, you just shoot right through the water. See where I'm going with this? You can't do that at a park or at a sandbox, but in a pool, you can. Now, Sutton's older sister Charlie was she was more ready for pictures. She's a little bit older and she was a little more excited. And I think you'll notice in this next clip, notice the placement of the sun. It was very bright. I technically would have liked it to be a little brighter, but they slept in a little longer from their nap, so we have to shoot with the light we have, right? I put the light behind her head because I thought it was a really nice effect, kind of that backlit look. And she was just having a great time. If you notice her beautiful expressions, that's what you want. Can you help me with some posing?
No.
Oh, come on, let's do it.
No.
Where you are is perfect. Can you?
Right at me.
Oh, beautiful. Wait, wait, wait. Come back. Oh, I love it. Smile. Smile. Oh, I love that. Oh, I love that. I love that. See what I mean? Is that the most precious expression? What mother wouldn't want a high-res image of that burned onto a disc? Every mother I know, am I right? I mean, can you think of a more precious gift to give family and friends and grandparents? All in all, we had a great, great afternoon there at the Phoenix Pool. Some of you might be wondering, Missy, how did you keep those children excited and energetic for almost 2 hours? Here's a little tip from me to you. A lot of juice boxes and a great big Costco bag of Skittles. It just keeps their energy level up. When they crash in a big way, but you know what? We're done and it's okay. And actually, they go home with mom. So if they're a little upset in the car, at least your job is done. Am I right? Now I got home and I uploaded all those images to Picnic. And I picnicked the heck out of them, let me tell you. I added some light flares and I turned some of them black and white, which was a real nice feature. And I added some kind of fun graphics to them and burned them all onto a DVD and I sent it off to their mom. And you know, I think when all is said and done, that's probably the best $150 she'll have ever spent because she's going to treasure that DVD for years and years and years to come. Am I right? You know I'm right. So thanks again, everybody, for joining me today. I hope you learned a little something. And until next time, bye.